Emerald Tablet 13, The Keys of Life and Death. List ye, O man, hear ye the wisdom. Hear ye the word that shall fill thee with life. Hear ye the word that shall banish the darkness. Hear ye the voice that shall banish the night. Mystery and wisdom have I brought to my children, knowledge and power descended from old. Know ye not that all shall be open when ye shall find the oneness of all? One shall ye be with the masters of mystery, conquerors of death and masters of life. Aye, ye shall learn of the flowers of Amenti, the blossoms of life that shine in the hall. In spirit shall ye reach the halls of Amenti, and bring back the wisdom that liveth in light. Know ye the gateway to power of secret, know ye the gateway to life is through death. Aye, through death, but not as ye know death, but a death that is life and is fire and is light. Desireth thou to know the deep hidden secret? Look into thy heart where the knowledge is bound. Know that in thee the secret is hidden, the source of all life and the source of all death. List ye, O man, while I tell the secret, reveal unto thee the secret of old. Deep in earth's heart lies the flower, the source of the spirit that binds all in its form. For know ye that the earth is living in body, as thou art alive in thine own formed form. The flower of life is as thine own place of spirit and streams of the earth, as thine flows through thy form, giving of life to the earth and its children, renewing the spirit from form unto form. This is the spirit that is form of thy body, shaping and molding it into its form. Know ye, O man, that thy form is dual, balanced in polarity while form in its form. Know that when fast on thee death approaches, it is only because thy balance is shaken. It is only because one pole has been lost. Know that thy body, when in perfect balance, may never be touched by the finger of death. Aye, even accident may only approach when the balance is gone. When ye are in a balanced equilibrium, ye shall live on in time and not taste of death. Know that thou art the balanced completion, existing because of thy balance of poles. As in thee, one pole is drawn downward, fast from thee goes the balance of life. Then unto thee cold death approaches, and change must come to thine unbalanced life. Know that the secret of life in Amenti is the secret of restoring the balance of poles. All that exists has form, and is living because of the spirit of life in its pole. See ye not that an earth's heart is the balance of all things that exist and have been on its face? The source of thy spirit is drawn from earth's heart, for in thy form thou art one with the earth. When thou hast learned to hold thine own balance, thou shalt thou draw on the balance of earth. Exist then shalt thou with earth as existing, changing in form only when earth too shall change. Tasting not of death, but one with this planet, holding thy form till all passes away. List ye, O man, whilst I give the secret, so that ye too shall taste not of change. 1 hour each day shall I lie with thy head pointed to the place of the positive pole, north. 1 hour each day shall thy head be pointed into the place of the negative pole, south. Whilst thy head is placed to the northward, hold thou thy consciousness from the chest to the head. And when thy head is placed southward, hold thou thy thought from chest to the feet. Hold thou in balance once in each 7, and thy balance will retain the whole of its strength. Aye, if thou be old, thy body will freshen, and thy strength will become as a youth. This is the secret known to the masters, by which they hold off the fingers of death. Neglect not to follow the path I have shown, for when thou hast passed beyond years to 100, to neglect it will mean the coming of death. Hear ye my words, and follow the pathway. Keep thou thy balance, and live on in life. Hear ye, O man, and list to my voice, list to the wisdom that gives thee of death. When at the end of thy work appointed, thou mightest desire to pass from this life, pass to the plain where the sons of the morning live, and have been as children of light. Pass without pain, and pass without sorrow, into the plain where is eternal light. First, lie at rest when thy head to be eastward. Fold thou thy hands at the source of thy life, the solar plex. Place thou thy consciousness in the life seat. whirl it and divide to north and to south. Send thou the one out toward the northward, send thou the other out to the south. Relax thou thy hold upon thy being, forth from thy form will thy silver spark fly, upward and onward to the sun of the morning, blending with light at once with its source. There it shall flame till desire shall be created, then shall return to a place and a form. Know ye, O men, that thus pass the great souls, changing at will from life unto life. Thus ever passes the Avatar, willing his death as he wills his own life. List ye, O man, drink of my wisdom, learn ye the secret that is master of time. Learn ye how those ye call masters are able to remember the lives of the past. Great is the secret, yet easy to master, giving to thee the mastery of time. When upon thee death fast approaches, fear not, but know ye are master of death. Relax the body, resist not with tension. Place in thy heart the flame of thy soul, swiftly then sweep it to the seat of the triangle, hold for a moment, then move to the goal. This thy goal is a place between thine eyebrows, the place where the memory of life must hold sway. Hold thou thy flame there in thy brain seat until the fingers of death grasp thy soul. Then as thou pass through the state of transition, surely the memories of life shall pass too. Then shalt the past be as one with the present, then shall the memory of all be retained. Free shalt thou be from all retrogression, the things of the past shall live in today. Man, ye have heard the voice of my wisdom. Follow, ye shall live through the ages thine. End of Tablet 13. Supplementary, Emerald Tablet 14. List ye, O man, to the deep hidden wisdom, lost to the world since the time of the dwellers, lost and forgotten by men of this age. Know ye this earth is but a portal, guided by powers unknown to man. Yet the dark lords hide the entrance that leads to the heaven-born land. Know ye the way to the sphere of the Aralu is guarded by barriers open only to light-born man. Upon earth, I am the holder of the keys to the gates of the sacred land. Command I, by the powers beyond me, to leave the keys to the world man. Before I depart, I give ye the secrets of how ye may rise from the bondage of darkness, cast off the fetters of flesh that have bound ye, rise from the darkness into the light. Know ye, the soul must be cleansed of its darkness, ere ye may enter the portals of light. Thus I established among ye the mysteries, so that the secrets may always be found. I, though man may fall into darkness, always a light will shine as a guide, hidden in darkness, veiled in symbols, always the way to the portals will be found. Man in the future will deny the mysteries, but always the way the seeker will find. Now I command ye to maintain my secrets, giving only to those ye have tested, so that pure may not be corrupted, so that the power of truth may prevail. List ye now to the unveiling of mystery, list to the symbols of mysteries I give. Make of it a religion only for those will its essence remain. Regions, there are two between this life and the great one, traveled by the souls who depart from the earth. Duat, the home of the powers of illusion. Sekhet, Hetsep, and the house of the gods. Osiris, the symbol of the guard of the portal, who turns back the souls of unworthy men. Beyond lies the sphere of the heaven-born powers. Aralu, the land where the great ones have passed. There, when my work among men have been finished, will I join the great ones of my ancient home. Seven are the mansions of the house of the mighty. Three guards the portal of each house from the darkness. 15 the ways that lead to Duat. 12 are the houses of the lords of illusion, facing four ways, each of them different. 42 are the great powers, judging the dead who seek for the portal. 4 are the sons of Horus. 2 are the guards of east and west, Isis, the mother who pleads for her children, queen of the moon, reflecting the sun. Ba is the essence, living forever. Ka is the shadow that man knows his life. Ba cometh not until Ka is incarnate. These are mysteries to preserve through the ages. Keys are they of life and death, Hear ye now the mystery of mysteries. Learn of the circle, beginningless and endless, the form of He who is one and in all. Listen and hear it, go forth and apply it. Thus will ye travel the way that I go, mystery in mystery, yet clear to the light born, the secret of all I now will reveal. I will declare a secret to the initiated, but let the door be wholly shut against the profane. 3 is the mystery. Come from the Great One. Hear, and light on thee will dawn. In the primeval dwell 3 unities. Other than these, none can exist. These are the equilibrium, source of creation. One God, one truth, one point of freedom. 3 come forth from the 3 of the balance, all life, all good, all power. 3 are the qualities of God in His light home, infinite power, infinite wisdom, infinite love. 3 are the powers given to the masters to transmute evil, assist good, use discrimination. 3 are the things inevitable for God to perform, manifest power, wisdom, and love. 3 are the powers creating all things, divine love possessed of perfect knowledge, divine wisdom knowing all possible means, divine power possessed by the joint will of divine love and wisdom. 3 are the circles or states of existence, the circle of light where dwells nothing but God, and only God can traverse it. The circle of chaos where all things by nature arise from death. The circle of awareness where all things spring from life. All things animate are of 3 states of existence. Chaos or death. Liberty in humanity and felicity of heaven. 3 necessities control all things, beginning in the great deep, the circle of chaos, plenitude in heaven. 3 are the path of the soul. Man, liberty, light. 3 are the hindrances, lack of endeavor to obtain knowledge, non-attachment to God, attachment to evil. In man, the 3 are manifest. 3 are the kings of power within. 3 are the chambers of the mysteries, found yet not found in the body of man. Hear ye now of He who is liberated, free from the bondage of life into light. Knowing the source of all worlds shall be open, aye, even the gates of Aralu shall not be barred. Yet heed, O man, who wouldst enter heaven, if ye be not worthy, better it be to fall into the fire. Know ye, the celestials pass through the pure flame, at every revolution of the heavens they bathe in the fountains of light. List ye, O man, to this mystery. Long in the past before ye were man born, I dwelled in ancient Atlantis. There in the temple, I drank of the wisdom, poured as a fountain of light from the dweller. Give the key to descend to the presence of light in the great world. Stood I before the Holy One, enthroned in the flower of fire, veiled was He by the lightning to the darkness, else my soul by the glory had been shattered. Forth from the feet of His throne, like the diamond, rolled forth 4 rivers of flame from His footstool. Rolled through the channels of clouds to the man world, filled was the hall with spirits of heaven. Wonder of wonders was the starry palace, above the sky like a rainbow, fire and sunlight, were formed the spirits. Sang they the glories of the Holy One. Then from the midst of the fire came a voice, behold the glory of the first cause. I beheld that light, high above all darkness, reflected in my own being. I attained, as it were, to the God of all gods, the Spirit Son, the Sovereign of the Sun Sphere. Again came the voice, there is one, even the first, who hath no beginning, who hath no end, who hath made all things, who govern all, who is good, who is just, who illumines, who sustains. Then from the throne there poured a great radiance, surrounding and lifting my soul by its power. Swiftly I moved through the spaces of heaven, shown was I the mystery of mysteries, shown the secret heart of the cosmos. Carried was I to the land of Aralu, stood before the lords in their houses. Opened they the doorway so I might glimpse the primeval chaos, shuddered my soul to the vision of horror, shrank back my soul from the ocean of darkness. Then saw I the need for the barriers, saw the need for the lords of Araloo. Only they with their infinite bounds could stand in the way of the inpouring chaos, only they could guard God's creation. Then did I pass around the circle of eight, saw all the souls who had conquered the darkness, saw the splendor of light where they dwelled. Longed I to take my place in their circle, but longed I also for the way I had chosen when I stood in the halls of Amenti and made my choice the work I would do. Passed I from the halls of Araloo down to the earth space where my body lay. Arose I from the earth where I rested, stood I before the dweller, gave my pledge to renounce my great right until my work on earth was completed, until the age of darkness be passed. List ye, O man, to the words I have given thee. In them shall ye find the essence of life. Before I return to the halls of Amenti, taught shall ye be the secrets of secrets, how ye too may rise to the light. Preserve them and guard them, hide them in symbols, so the profane will laugh and renounce. In every land form ye the mysteries, make the way hard for the seekers to tread. Thus will the weak and the wavering be rejected. Thus will the secrets be hidden and guarded, hid till the time when the wheel shall be turned. Through the dark ages, waiting and watching, my spirit shall remain in the deep hidden land. When one has passed all the trials of the outer, summon ye me by the key that ye hold. Then will I, the initiator, answer, come from the halls of the gods in Amenti. Then will I receive the initiate, give him the words of power. Hark ye, remember these words of warning. Bring not to me one lacking in wisdom, impure in heart or weak in his purpose, else I will withdraw from ye your power to summon me from the place of my sleeping. Go forth and conquer the elements of darkness, exalt in thy nature thine essence of light. Now go ye forth and summon thy brothers, so that I may impart the wisdom to light thy path when my presence is gone. Come to the chamber beneath my temple, eat not food until 3 days are past. There will I give thee the essence of wisdom, so that with power ye may shine among men. There will I give unto thee the secrets, so that ye too may rise to the heavens, God men in truth, as in essence ye be. Depart now and leave me while I summon those ye know of but ye know not. End of Tablet 14. Supplementary Emerald Tablet 15. Secret of Secrets. Now ye assemble my children, waiting to hear the secret of secrets, which shall give ye power to unfold the God-man, give ye the way to eternal life. Plainly shall I speak of the unveiled mysteries, no dark saying shall I give unto thee. Open thy ears now, my children, hear and obey the words that I give. First I shall speak of the fetters of darkness which bind ye in chains to the sphere of the earth. Darkness and light are both of one nature, different only in seeming, for each arose from the source of all. Darkness is disorder, light is order. Darkness transmuted is light of the light. This, my children, your purpose in being, transmutation of darkness to light. Hear ye now the mystery of nature, the relations of life to the earth where it dwells. Know ye, ye are threefold in nature, physical, astral, and mental in one. Three are the qualities of each of the natures, nine in all, above, so below. In the physical are these channels, the blood which moves in vertical motion, reacting on the heart to continue its beating. Magnetism, which moves through the nerve path, carrier of energies to all cells and tissues. Akasa, which flows through channels, subtle yet physical, completing the channels. Each of the three attuned with each other, each affecting the life of the body. Form they the skeletal framework through which the subtle ether flows. In their mastery lies the secret of life in the body, relinquished only by will of the adept when his purpose in moving is done. Three are the natures of the astral, mediator is between above and below, not of the physical, not of the spiritual, but able to move above and below. Three are the natures of mind, carrier of the will of the Great One, arbitrator of cause and effect in thy life. Thus is formed the threefold being, directed from above by the power of four. Above and beyond man's threefold nature lies the realm of the spiritual self. Four is it in qualities, shining each of the planes of existence, but 13 in one of the mystical number. Based on the qualities of man are the brothers. Each shall direct the unfoldment of being. Each shall channel be of the Great One. On earth, man is in bondage, bond by space and time to the earth plane, encircling each planet. A wave of vibration binds him to his plane of unfoldment. Yet within man is the key to releasement. Within man may freedom be found. When ye have released the self from the body, rise to the uttermost bounds of your earth plane. Speak ye the word, Dor-E-Lil-La, D-O-R-E-L-I-L-L-A. Then, for a time your light will be lifted, free may ye pass the barriers of space, for a time of half of the sun, 6 hours. Free may ye pass the barriers of the earth plane, see and know those who are beyond thee. Yea, to the highest worlds may ye pass, see your own possible heights of unfoldment, know all earthly futures of soul. Bound are ye in your body, but by the power ye may be free. This is a secret whereby bondage shall be placed by freedom for thee. Calm let thy mind be, at rest be thy body, conscious only of freedom from flesh. Center thy being on the goal of thy longing. Think over and over that thou wouldst be free. Think of this word, La-Um-I-L-Gan, L-A-U-M-I-L-G-A-N. Over and over in thy mind, let it sound, drift with the sound to the place of thy longing, free from the bondage of flesh by thy will. Hear ye, while I give the greatest of secrets, how ye may enter the halls of Amenti, enter the place of the immortals as I did, stand before the lords in their places. Lie down in rest of thy body, calm thy mind so no thought disturbs thee. Pure must ye be in mind and in purpose, else only failure will come unto thee. Vision Amenti as I have told in my tablets, long with fullness of heart to be there. Stand before the lords in thy mind's eye, pronounce the words of power I give mentally. Mekit El Shabel, Hail Shur Ben El Shabrut Zin Ephraim Kwar El. M-E-K-U-T E-L S-H-A-B E-L H-A-L-E S-U-R B-E-N E-L Z-A-B-R-U-T Z-I-N E-F-R-I-M Q-U-A-R E-L Relax thy mind and thy body, then be sure your soul be calm. Now give I the key to Shambhala, the place where my brothers live in the darkness, darkness but filled with light of the sun. Darkness of earth, but light of the spirit, guides for ye when my day is done. Leave thou thy body as I have taught thee. Pass to the barriers of the deep, hidden place. Stand before the gates and their guardians. Command thy entrance by these words. I am the light. In me is no darkness. Free am I of the bondage of the night. Open thou the way of the 12 and the 1, so I may pass to the realm of the wisdom. When they refuse thee, as surely they will, command them to open by words of power. I am the light. For me, there are no barriers. Open, I command, by the secret of secrets. Edom El Ahim, Zabert Zer Adom, E-D-O-M, E-L, A-H-I-M, S-A-B-B-E-R-T, Z-U-R-A-D-O-M. Then, if thy words have been truth of the highest, open for thee, thy barriers will fall. Now I leave thee, my children, down, yet up, to the hall shall I go. Win ye the way to me, my children, truly my brothers shall ye become. Thus finish I my writings, keys, let them be to those who come after, but only to those who seek my wisdom, for only for these am I the key and the way. End of tablet and of book.